Hello, my name is Peter Phelps of Phelps3D, and in this FreeCAD 016 tutorial, I'm going to discuss how to create a clothespin type device. Now, you may be thinking, oh, well, clothespins are so cheap, why would I ever want to use that? Why would I want to model it? Well, here's an example where I made a bag clip using the clothespin. Here I create a magnet that I could stick on my fridge and then clip a picture to, or other list or something else that you could put up there. Here is one that attaches to a PVC shelf setup. So, you know, it just depends on what you're doing. And of course, you know, you break your things all the time, so you probably have springs sitting around somewhere if you use clothespins at all. So I'm starting here, new document, part design. I'm going to create a sketch, and I'm going to do the XZ plane. Say OK. And what we want to do is we want to draw or sketch out the basic profile of the device. So I'm going to start and try to get right on the origin here. I'm going to come out here, go up, I didn't quite make that. I'm going to be deleting this section because it's going to be a circle. Come over. Hit escape. Zoom in. Make sure this is attached there. Okay. So the end of this is 1.5 millimeters. Sure that that's pinned there. Yeah, okay. Then from the end to the notch is 45.5 millimeters. So I didn't make this big enough. Pin it to the line so it's even with this one. And then the space from the notch to the end is 24.5. Down. Okay, and the notch itself is 3.5. Set this to 3.52. About 2.5 tall. I thought, oh, so I have two lines. And then that went away. There we go. Okay, so this is probably supposed to be over here. Okay, let's just go. Okay, this should be straight and millimeters. To here is 33 millimeters. I'm going to go ahead and just delete this. Put it back over here. Thank you. almost a 45 degree angle, but I'm going to measure. The height should be the same as that other one, the 5.8. Okay. There to the notch is 27. Let's see, 26.2 is what I'm going to do. This isn't a very big notch. That was small, actually. Take this, move it. Okay, so this is like a millimeter by a millimeter or something. Let's try 2 millimeters. Now the fun part. We need to make 2 circular cuts in to it. Or so this is 5.4 diameter, so I need a circle that's 2.7. Go ahead and draw the other circle over here. Hit escape. Okay, 2.7. And this is the tricky part, because you got to try to figure out about where the circle's center would have been. So. Or you can try to figure out the distance by, but it's kind of tricky doing it that way. You could try to do it just by trying to determine the distance from this to this, but I don't think there's a way to just do that type of measurement. You have to do it by the point, which means you got to try to figure out where the center is. So I'm gonna say 8 high. Oops, that's way too far. How did I get that? Well, 7.5. Let's see if that. No, still way too far. Sorry. This is where I said it's kind of tricky. Let's try 6 instead and see. That looks a little better. Okay, and then the other one. It says 6.4, so 3.2. Point 2. Oh, your radius. Okay. And then okay, and then what we're going to do is we need to figure out how far away the centers were from the ends. I'm going to say that was 29. I'm going to go from the tip to the other one. Looks like 16. We click this point, say 16. And then you gotta trim it between those. Oops. Sometimes this doesn't work exactly. So that's not doing what I wanted. So let's see if I can do this instead. Sometimes think those got connected right. Alright, and I'll try the Trimex over here again. Oopsie. No, you flipped. Okay, maybe not the Trimex. Maybe I'll just select this. Just selecting the whole thing. Sorry. To be connected or it won't work. All right. Well, if everything's connected right, I gotta double check the okay, let's see. Let's see if this will work. We're going to take that. And we're going to pad it 9.8 millimeters. And it didn't do it. So something's wrong. Okay. Because it should have padded right then. Let's go part design. Quality sketch. Find two missing coincidences. Okay. Fix them. Invalid constraints. No invalid constraints. Okay. Close. Now let's see if it pads. Still didn't. That means something's still wrong. Let's go back into the sketch. And we gotta find out where it's broken. I might have forgotten that one. Okay. Let's try it again. I break it. Then this has some really screwy thing. This dot is out here. Sorry. Somehow I made a mess there when I did the trimming and the deleting of the line. Let's see if that will. Now pad. Yay! What was the number again? Nine point eight. So you can take that. Let's see. If take that, mirror it, and I'm not sure. I think XE plane. No, let's just put one right next to it. Which let's try me. Why did I? Why is he right? Let's X is on. Sorry. Let's try that one. Well, that kind of worked. Take that. Move it up. Got your clip. Let's see, I think it's still overlapping. There we go. You only actually need to export one of these if you want, so I'm gonna go file, save. Close pin. File export. And then, like I said, you can add different things to it to make it do different things. Like I did, I made a little plate on one side that I could attach a magnet to, or you can do different various things just by modeling that. Of course, you always want to check your models in NetFab Basic. Make sure that they're printable. there should be the completely clean, no red triangle. So that is 3D printable. Hope this helps. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.